Hello guys, my name is Kuning, welcome to this new video, and today we are going to be once again playing Hearts of Iron 4. However, today I'll be playing the new DLC called Awakened Tiger. However, I sort of strongly disagree with that calling, since I do have a feeling like it should be called something like putting a tiger back to sleep, because this is literally what happens in the entirety of this game. To make you fully understand, there are a few changes if it comes to the focus trees, and I'll show you what kind of changes I'm talking about exactly. Those changes are basically mainly down to the German Reich over here, where you can actually choose the Kaiserreich instead of, like, you know, the Hitler's approach to Second World War. You'll basically go back to the World War I times and go like that. Don't get me wrong, the nation is incredibly powerful in terms of, like, raw factories and stuff like that. It does a lot of stuff. The problem with the country is quite simply the fact that you are basically held by all, like, you know, your balls are literally clenched somewhere and you, like, can't move from the middle of Europe. You're literally stuck over here and you just can't do anything from over here. Or, well, you can affect stuff like Norway, Finland, you can attack Poland without even attacking, but generally said, there is a significant problem with the fact that you are basically a super nation that is basically stuck over here because everybody around you hates you for one reason or another reason. Basically, everybody hates you. There is also another problem to the Kaiserreich, and it is the constant bombardment with, like, the terrible messages. You constantly get, like, negative effects, constantly get bad messages and stuff like that, which gets to be quite annoying overall. And while the nation is quite powerful, it's definitely one of the most broken nations added to the game, period, I've gotta say that it's irritating to play, and I'm never going to play it. Like, freaking ever. Probably in a single player, but I'm never gonna play it on a video and record it. Then if it comes to the East, usually what was happening previously was, like, the China being the underdog, but they were capable of defeating the friends with the power of friendship. Basically, that literally sums up what was happening. The China wasn't capable of defeating Japan by themselves, so they united the United Chinese Front and defeated the Japan together. That's what was happening previously most of the time. However, nowadays, it's basically, you know, your mom gay. China responds, no you. Then Japan, you're the lesbian. And China dies. That's what happens. Japan just steamrolls all around the freaking China and is destroyed, so it's quite annoying to see that. So, in the previous video, I was asking you guys which nation you want me to play, and after counting out all of the votes, I found out that only a single person voted for France, and I tried to actually play France. There was a single problem with that. France is super, super freaking boring. I'm not even kidding about that. The France is super boring because literally only thing you do as a wall, as France, is basically join the Second World War and defend yourself. That's all. That's literally all. I just stood there for 4 freaking years until the Second World War started, and then I got to do some shit. And more precisely, the only thing I did was literally draw some front lines with German Reich. That was everything. That was all of the things that I've done for the entire game. So, you know, the French, like, yeah, it's not a bad kind of a nation, but they are incredibly powerful, but they are really boring to play. And especially they are super boring for making videos. So I was wondering about the different nation that I could play. Firstly, I could literally play Japan, but they are literally steamrolling over China, and you know, that is a bit too easy for, in my opinion. And I could also play with Soviet Union again, but I played with them previously. Already I've done one video, so I didn't want to play with them again. I could also play with German Reich and go with the Kaiserreich. But as I already mentioned once, there is the problem that's irritating to play. So the last nation that I was wondering about was not the United Kingdom, was not the United States, but Italy. Yes, Italy with Mussolini, because right now we got those formidable nations and we are gonna be capable of form the Roman Empire. And that's basically my goal for this game. So let's start with the Italy difficulty. Regular historical AI focuses everything alright. We will completely mess this world up. I've actually tried a bit, so I know basically what am I gonna do, especially towards the beginning of the game. Also, I do need to know one thing, and that is whether or not I'm actually even recording, because I turned on the recording, but I do not remember if I didn't actually turn on streaming. No, I actually turned on the recording. That's good, that's good. So we have started as Italy. Let's get our national focus. From the beginning, I need to get triumph in Africa as quickly as possible, so I'll be capable of supporting national Spain and getting also some claims on Yugoslavia. But before I'll be capable of getting a triumph in Africa, I need to actually defeat Ethiopia over here, which is not difficult, I must say. It's really freaking easy, but it's gonna take some time. I literally can't steamroll them or anything like that from the beginning, so, you know, I can't take the triumph of Africa straight from the beginning of a game. Instead of that, I'm gonna get the Ethiopian War Logistics, which will give me some infrastructure and some naval bases over here in Eritrea and Somaliland. There we go. Ethiopian War Logistics. That was probably the best choice so far that I found that there is, basically, from the focuses at the beginning of a game. There are possible choices, obviously, Army Primacy. But I don't really feel like it's sort of good, because here, you definitely do want the industrial effort. The modernized artillery is also quite good, but well. Let's keep talking about that. Now, if it comes to research, we are obviously gonna get the basic industry stuff going here for some bonus production efficiency cap. Then we are gonna get construction for faster construction speed. I'm completely ignoring the factory repair speed. For now, we do not need it. Then we are gonna get electronical mechanical engineering for faster research. And lastly, we can choose something. And if it comes to choosing something else, I'm probably gonna choose this, which is gonna increase the power of my infantry as a wall. And that's something I definitely do want. Let's get you over here. You guys, on the other hand, will be another squadron. Squadron? Can it be called like that? I don't know. Then, we got some free civilian factories. Alright. Civilian factories. We are first gonna build just a shit ton of them. Alright. Just so we will be capable of building a shit ton of them later on. Strategy, yeah. So we are just gonna fill all of this with civilian factories, and we are good to go for now. We got some free military factories, so we are gonna fill them with primarily infantry weapons. We got enough support equipment, but is there anything else we do need? We will need artillery, so I know that for sure. So let's get at least three of them from the beginning. And let's get another infantry thingy going over here. There we go. We also got some free dockyards. So let's see. We got, oh my god, we got so many battleships. We actually do not need the battleships. Or we could keep this one with five dockyards, working on them. You'll be changed for something else. I do know that they are two light cruisers, and I know that one of them is a lot more powerful one. Give me a second, fire range. Alright, this one is the lot more powerful one. Then we got destroyers, Maestrale, is it the better one? Once again, there are two choices if I'm correct, and one of them is a lot more powerful. So let's see. I don't know. I do have a feeling like this one is once again the better one. And lastly, there is a Sirena. I know that the Sirena is better. So let's go with this. Nice. Now, we got planes with no region assigned. We do not want them to have any region assigned, at least not from the beginning of a game. I'm also gonna send these guys over here, just because why the heck not. I'm gonna get as much support as this possible, especially from strategical bombers. So, you guys will go over here. Nice. Alright, now, what do we need? We need some unit training, so we are gonna get 10 divisions into training. Division Celera, we are gonna get 5 of these. Nice. No location set. We are gonna set this location because we will go into war against Yugoslavia quite soon enough. So they need to be as close as possible. And we are almost all set and ready to go. We just need to trade a few things, especially with whom would I want to trade with? Who would I want to trade with? I wonder. The Romania. I could trade with the Romania to, like, you know, befriend them and then, like, attack Greece and Turkey and go stuff like that while these guys would be on my side, because I can obviously choose that. Look at this. Trim with Africa, then I can go, I'll take down Yugoslavia, then I've got to befriend Bulgaria, I can take the Albania, and I can befriend Romania. I do not have anything like war on Romania, so I could actually trade with the Romania straight from the get-go, like this. Nice. I also need some rubber. Whom is gonna give me rubber? Obviously, France. I know that we are gonna be at a war with them, but I'm gonna try to, like, somehow convince them, like, you know, we are the good guys, you know, the allies are the bad guys. Just kill all of the allies. We do not want them. Let's see, Czechoslovakia. I didn't know. If it comes to tungsten, is it a tungsten? No, it's a chromium. This is tungsten. I'm gonna get it from Soviet Union. Why the heck not? We got a trade all set and... Is it a freaking dog? Whatever. Alright, we should be all set and ready... Nope, we are not all set and ready to go just yet. The reason behind this is quite simply the fact that these guys are not in an army. Oh, you are in an army, but you don't have the battlefront. So we are gonna get a battlefront over there, you're gonna get an offensive line over here. So we will push for it, but my main focus will be on you guys, which will literally just stampede all the way over here and then go into the Addis Ababa so they'll surrender as quickly as possible. If it comes to the southern guys, you know what, you just defend, alright? You just defend. Now, you're gonna be assigned a leader, let's see whom. This guy is not all that good for defense. Do we have anyone? Well, he's best for defense. So I'm gonna get that guy for you. You're gonna get this guy, which... I'm wondering if we... Holy damn, you got a lot of stuff. But you don't get any experience at all. Man. Max entrenchment plus one. Alright. You're good at defending. You know what? I'm gonna get you over here, but you are gonna be assigned, not Giovanni Messe, on the other side. He's pretty damn good at attacking, so we are gonna be assigned that guy. Now, unassigned divisions, obviously here are some unassigned divisions, so we are gonna be in another army. And that's about it. Alright. We should be all set and ready to go. Also, I'm recording this during a day, which means, once again, there are gonna be budgies bitching behind me. I'm also gonna merge all of the navies that we got inside of our entire... Can it be called empire? I don't really feel like it's empire. Well, let's merge you all, so it will be a little bit easier to handle you. Now, you're gonna get over here. Let's wait for this guy to get here. Oh, I should speed the game up a bit. How long? 23 more days. Oh my god. Alright. Let's just start attacking without him. I didn't want to start attacking without him because it could be quite annoying, but, well... That guy will take some time to actually get there. Over here, I'll just try to defend as hard as I can. I could potentially even manual attack, which is also a possibility. Like this. Less than a day. I know that manual attacking, especially from the south, so from the Somali land, is probably not a good idea, but... Well, it's my game, alright? I'm playing it. 23 days. That is not good. That is not good at all. I'm not gonna attack with these guys. These guys will be attacking, but the rest won't be attacking. Oh my god, could you shut the fuck up? Give me a second. Give me a second. I'm gonna shut the... Alright, I'm back. Hopefully they'll be quiet till the end of the video. Also, we ordered it on Evit Concentrate with something. And that is... Oh, we haven't... We did not overdo it. Just Romania, which sort of dislikes us for some unknown reason. Why? Could you... I do not understand why you don't like me, but screw you then. I'm gonna get my fair share of oil from you. Like this? Nice. For some reason, they do not like me. Over here, I'm winning this battle. That's good. We need to kill these guys before we'll be capable of advancing. Over here, these guys are stopped for some reason. 15 more days. Here we can see the reason why everybody makes jokes from like the Benito Mussolini. Because I'm playing him and I suck at playing this game. Strategic bombing, close air support, air superiority, all of these. Now, we got some naval bombers. I'm not gonna use them. I'm not gonna use naval bombing or anything like that. Here we go. Battlefield support. Here we can see like the length of battles is dropping down significantly. That's definitely amazing. I'm doing this primarily just to train my guys because as you might see they are... Look at that experience rising up. It's amazing. So good. So good. Right. You will actually get an offensive line over here. Like this. Nice. Start attacking them. Hopefully these guys will be dumb enough to actually not help them. In which case I'm gonna get basically free land over there. This battle is lasting like a freaking month. Can you just kill them finally? Christ, man. Christ. Same goes to these battles. Like, what the hell? I'm over here, I'm going straight for the Addis Ababa. For the capital. And over here, I'm just defending the Mogadishu. Or how it's called. Give me a second. Can I see it? That's a Somali land. I do not need to see that. But there is a town. Yeah, Mogadishu. I do not know the pronunciation, like... African pronunciation. I'm trying to defend this town because once Addis Ababa is taken down and they'll capture this thing will become a capital. And it's actually quite a bit of a big town. It may not seem like a big town, but it's seriously a big town, at least for African standards. Right, there we go. No, you won't be going there. You will be going here. Because these guys got less organization, so we will be capable of destroying them quicker. Right. There we go. This battle is soon enough gonna be won. 7 more days, this battle 40 more days. Jesus, that is taking so long. It's getting annoying. Man, really annoying. Just defeat them, 6 more days. You guys are not moving. Once you will start moving, I'll have to start defending this territory. Alright, 1 infantry division left. One more, there we go. We won. We just won. But I've paused the game for some unknown reason. There we go. We're moving. Are we moving? Doesn't seem like that. As long as they are not gonna be moving, it's alright. And just in case they are gonna start mobilizing, I'm gonna put this guy over here. But you are gonna push their capital. You over here are already pushing out quite nicely, that is amazing. These guys are soon enough gonna be down. It's good. I just need to take down the Addis Ababa. Which, and it says that the battle will last less than a day, which I don't know if it's a bug or something like that, but well. Its organization is too low to advance. Weird. Less than a day.
These heroes have dead low organization? None of you has low organization. What's the matter with you guys? Seriously. Alright. There we go. You guys in the meantime are absolutely wrecking the south. I didn't want to do that. I actually wanted to give you an order to directly attack Addis Ababa. Once you get the possibility to do that. But right now, just kill these guys or just have a fight with them or whatever the hell you please. How the hell am I losing this battle? Well, they got some mountaineers over here. So that's probably the reason why am I losing. Come on, push their capital, that's all I'm asking for. I'm gonna speed it up, and for some reason we are losing from time to time. It's quite weird and quite scary if you would ask me. I don't like that. Go over there. And like this. Nice. Alright. We can't afford to lose this battle. Is there a capital? We are starting to win it. That's amazing. Right? Where is it? That guy? There we go. There he is. He's gonna join the battle soon enough. And he's gonna win it single-handedly. It's also quite... I should point out one thing. And that is that we got a lot of stability... No, not stability. We got a lot of war support. 70%. I wasn't in a battle, obviously. I'm in a battle, so it's like, how much? 50%. When I was playing, like, yesterday with Germany, I had like 5% war support when I started it, so... Ethiopian war logistics. Should I wait with it? No, I'm not gonna wait. I'm gonna go with industrial effort. There we go. Still can't pronounce it. Remilitarized Rhineland. That's not good. Well, for me, it's definitely good, but for rest of the world, it's not good. Oh, they finally rounded it up to 5% from the previous 4.9. That's got to be quite annoying from time to time. How the hell are we still losing it? Oh my god. Would you look at that? Alright. We have got to defeat them no matter what. What will this mean for Spain? Well, nothing good. Nothing good at all. We're gonna start supporting them. I also forgot to put my troops into training. Reserve set. So we are gonna select you guys. All of these guys which are on level 2. Or level 1 apparently. And let's get into the level... Let's get into the level 3. By training. You're also gonna be... I didn't know if it adds something, but we are going to be training in the Alps. Because why the heck not? But over here, I need to support the National Spain. How much can I... How many? Where is it? I can't. Oh, we must be at peace. Alright, we need to finish this battle in order to be... Send volunteers to them. Alright, come on. Come on, win this battle. There we go. We just need to take down their capital and we are Gucci. We are gonna be fine once we do that. Christ. How long is this siege? How long did this battle last? Christ. It's already like 3 months long. It's getting seriously annoying. Less than a day. Amazing. Come on, come on, come on. 7 days. 30 days. Why? Alright, screw it. I'm gonna go the old-fashioned way. The old-fastest way. Capturing everything around. and only then getting into an actual battle. Why does this take so long? It's getting seriously annoying. Right now, I'm gonna create a push over here. Just capturing all of these lands. Like this. Nice. You, in the meantime, will start getting all of this. Oh, it's not all that much. Oh, I actually turned on the game. Let's start researching this. Another reducement in research times. Please don't get the Mogadishu. Please don't get the Mogadishu. If you get, I'm completely freaking screwed. And also, why the hell? Now I understand why everybody loves the freaking Mussolini. I'm getting defeated by freaking Ethiopia. Let's just keep on attacking them. They got low organization right now, so we should be capable of winning a lot of wars. Right, we are once again sieging Addis Ababa. Once Addis Ababa is down, they are gonna be down completely. Right, is there any random land that I can go to, like, you know, to start capturing randomly? Well, there is some, but it's not much. Alright, one of you will stay here to defend, while the other one will cap. We need to cut off these guys. Because there is majority of their army. Also, how the hell am I still losing? How is this possible? Like, yeah, I do understand that I don't have all that many mountaineers, but Christ. This war is taking half a year. Half a freaking year with an African nation. Yeah, I'm not fighting at full strength, but still. Christ. Let's just all attack over here, so we will cut them off. I do not understand how we are still losing. There we go. Just keep them occupied. Oh my god. Freaking Addis Ababa. Never ending siege. Come on. Take them down. Just a bit longer. Why aren't you... Can't you just... What the hell is happening over here? Explain me that. Look at this. What is that shit? What? What? Can't I, like... Alright. That's certainly interesting. There we go. They finally got no capital. So we can start focusing on attacking this part. But you will be attacking this part. You'll start capturing all of this. Because they've taken it. Alright. Soon enough, there should be a peace deal. After I cap a few more lands. Because why the heck not? There is a new research. And another research. So we are gonna start getting... Am I gonna get bombed a lot? I don't feel like I'm gonna get bombed a lot. So concentrated industry. 100% and synthetic oil. I do not want to rely on Germany. If it comes to oil. Alright. Can't you, like, cancel the order? Over here. Over here, over here, and over here. Alright, I got a smarter way of planning it. Right, I didn't know how it's possible that this war is still lasting. I also do not understand what the fuck happened there with their capital. Like, you know, I was attacking them at the same time, like, what is this? I do not understand. Is it like some new glitch with, like, you know, the combat tools right now? Because I do have a feeling it is. Once this thing is gonna be taken down, they'll probably surrender. Or not. Not yet. Jesus, you're holding on for so freaking long, man. I do not understand why you haven't surrendered yet. Give me a second. Can I click on them? There you go. How close are you? Oh, that's a problem. I forgot that every single battle needs to last 6 months. I don't know why I thought that it can last less. Alright, right now what am I gonna get? War industrialist? Not yet. I'm gonna get... I don't need this guy. Not yet, at least. I could get this guy. Civil infantry construction speed, infrastructure construction speed. Yeah, captain of industry, definitely. We got 3 dockyards. What happened? Why do I have 3 dockyards? What? What? What happened? I already had... I don't know. What just happened? For some reason I thought that I'm creating like ships and all of a sudden my dockyard said nope, you're not gonna make more ships. Why? Because fuck you, that's why. I do not understand what happened. But whatever happened, I don't like it. There we go. Now, let's wait for a peace deal. We got some new corps over here. All of you are actually... You have already finished training, so let's get you over into this army. The new buys are gonna get into this thing. Start training, and that's all of them. I'm gonna have to start creating fighters. Right, so far so good, but we are not doing good over here. We need to somehow help them, but I can't. I can't send volunteers to them because I'm at a war with Ethiopia. And they can't surrender because, you know, 6 months. 6 months. Alright, let's just wait. Right now it's all about waiting till the Ethiopia surrenders. Turn on the speed of a game to max. There we are. There is gonna be a nasty little crunch. I don't know why I'm even fighting. You know what? I'm gonna do this. I'm not gonna waste any of my manpower on them. I'm just gonna defend my own territory because they are surely going to surrender. Right. Can I, like, shift click? Control, no. Oh, right click. Delete all orders. Delete all orders. We're gonna be over here. We're gonna be over here. Stay, 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 stay. Just stay. Just stay. Just stay. All of you, just stay. There we go. We've got to just defend our lands right now because they are going to surrender within a couple of days. 9 days or 10 days, I don't know how months work in this game. I remember that in Europa Universalis you had like these weird ass months for some reason. This is nationalist Spain? Whoa, that's weird. Oh, the nationalist Spain is gonna lose before I'll be capable of joining the battle. No, that's not good. At least not good for me. June 30th. There we go. What? What's the problem now? What? Alright, I thought that they are going to, like, you know, give it up after they're, like... You cannot draw a front line. So let's just spearhead the fuck out of them. Oh, now I do understand. I can just start pushing like crazy. There we go. Aggressive. For some reason they are holding on, like, what the hell is the problem? They got literally nothing left. Their capital has been taken away. They got no cities left. Well, this is the only city that they got left. Gondar. Also, one of you will go over here to cap it. And cut them off. Alright, I thought that the war will end within a month, but for some reason they are holding on to nothing. Can I, like, see how the bell is doing? Like, you know? How close they are to surrendering? Because, there we go. Take all states and turn down. There we go. Alright, that's good. That's good. We are fine. We're gonna go into this because you are already at level 3, all of you. I hope that there is a single guy that is not at level 3 and you will start going over here. Garrison, because why the heck not? Anyways, this video is way over 30 minutes long because I didn't know what happened with that freaking Ethiopia. So though, I'm gonna end this video right here. Hope you enjoyed it and I hope that I'll see you next time. By the way, in the future, especially in the next video, I wanna help out the nationalist Spain, and despite the fact that I do have a feeling like it's a bit too late. But in case I'm gonna be capable of helping them, I'm gonna try helping them. But for now, I also almost got the industrial effort too. Right after that, I'm gonna get into that triumph in Africa. So though, hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that I'll see you next time. Bye!